I think one of the most interesting things about your careers, I'm talking about early Metallica, before you had hits, you know, like big known songs, you guys would do cover versions, right? And the cover versions were very obscure. Lars, you would travel all over Europe and look for like really obscure cover versions and, you know, songs that you could cover. And you would do them. And then the band, people thought they were your originals, right?
We didn't tell anybody they weren't our songs. We just played them.
Isn't that the way you get started as a band? You got to sort of cover a song.
That's how the first year in L.A., 81, 82, we were down in L.A. playing songs by obscure bands from Europe that nobody had heard of. We didn't say these are not our songs, but we just went up and played them.
I was looking up some of them, right? Let's see. Here's a good one. I got something to say. What is it about doing covers? In other words, you don't have confidence in your own writing. Is that it?
That's it.
Yeah. You had not. Well, seriously, you had never written songs together, right?
Sure. Well, like anybody, you get influenced by stuff, and it forms your sound. It forms what you like. And we were just paying homage to that later with Garage Days and stuff. But in the early days, like Lars was saying, no one knew they were covers, and we loved them until it came time to record our demo when we hooked up with a record guy. Oh my God! Okay, we're going in and we're gonna make a demo, and well, we can't play this song. What do you mean? And then we had these really long, you know, drawn out epics. And what happened to all the short songs? Well, they were covers.
Doesn't it amaze you that you got? When did you guys start to get radio airplay? Like, you didn't get radio airplay your first couple of albums, did you?
No,
Who is the radio guys that believed in you enough to start playing Metallica music on the radio?
Remember the station in L.A. called KNAC?
Yeah, was KROQ on you guys early on, too?
They were a little more on the alternative and on the sort of the new wavy stuff. They didn't get into, like, the deep cuts and all that, but they played the few so-called hits along the way.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, a lot of college radio stations, for sure.
But don't you wear that as like a badge of honor that you guys kind of made it without radio?
Made it our way.
Yeah.
Playing live was it.
Is that it? That's why even with the new album, you got to go out and play it live.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't screw with that formula.
No, you can't fake that.
No.
You know, well, some people try.
Well, they do. A lot of bands now, that older bands, more established bands, are trying to put out a record and just hoping their fans will just go buy it. It doesn't work that way.
Right. Well, we're fortunate enough to be... have a following that is continuing to enjoy the honesty in our music and the fact that we love playing it. And, you know, we're not trying to phone it in. We're not trying to fake it. We're artists and we love what we do.
So what was the impetus behind doing an album? Was there a time you guys said to each other, you know, shit, why are we wasting our time? We could certainly cruise along on our hits and do our shows and make our money.
We still want to make art.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't retire as an artist. I mean, you just keep doing what you do. We know that route where you don't make any more albums. You kind of just end up in the fairs playing your hits. That is an option, but we don't want that option right now.
Yeah, you know what the thing is? I think we still have creative ideas that we think are relevant.
Right.
And you know, we want to get those out and make music with them.
We still haven't made a good record yet. One's better. Yeah.
But is that really true? Do you listen to your old music and go, we could have done this so much better?
Absolutely.
Isn't that a bitch?
But I think it's important to understand that we still enjoy jamming, you know? Like, whenever we put the instruments on, it's like being teenagers again. And it's fun still. And there's no shortage of ideas. With a lot of the older bands, they kind of burn out and they run out of ideas and they go to outside writers. But with us, our thing is that there's too many ideas, which is it's a blessing and a curse.
And when you say ideas, could it just be a riff? Like when you do Master of Puppets, who brought that riff, if you will, to the session?
That's, I think that was James's back in
that
the
was
day.
Yours, James?
Okay.
Do you remember? You
he's
don't,
like, okay, if you say
is that
so.
True? Is your memory shot that you don't
it's
remember?
It's pretty bad. And as far as that stuff goes, I don't know if it matters so much.
Why?
Well, it's still living and it's its thing. It was a contribution to whatever it was.
But I saw the greatest movie where Jimmy Page is talking about how he came up with the riff for Cashmere.
The one with Jack White in it also.
Yeah, I love that. I love that. I love to know about that. So when you've got a song that's as popular as Master of Puppets, you don't recall coming up with the
riff?
In
our band, I think in our band, it's always been about the collective.
Right.
You know, a lot of those guys back in those days, in the 60s, 70s, they all were about themselves. So they were their own entities. They were all autonomous. We've only ever existed within a group setup.
In that movie where you're talking about, I think it's cool, you know, Jimmy remembers how, what he was influenced by or not by, and
yeah,
here's what I was thinking and all of that. Maybe he remembers it. Maybe it's just a cool story.
Yeah. Right.
Either way, it's great.
Yeah.
But I do remember playing Master of Puppets in the stinky little garage in Carlson.
Year was that?
85.
Yeah. Do you feel like that's going to be one of your legendary tunes when you're kind of doing that, or you just don't even know?
God, it's weird. It's weird to think, you know, we're up there playing Master of Puppets, screaming and going fast, and there's some little kids down in the front going, Master! And I'm thinking, what?
What?
Really? You like this?
Because you remember what it was like to come up with that, and you don't even, when you write a song, you don't know that somebody's going to resonate with that, right? It's such a mystery. It doesn't matter how big the band
30,
is.
It's 31 years ago. It's crazy.
Do you ever feel...
You can try and figure it out, but it never works that way.
So what's the key to being a great band? You just got to go with your heart and say,
absolutely,
this sounds good to me, right?
Yes.
You can't try to predict what the public is going to like.
We've always hovered on the outer fringes of all that stuff anyway, like we were just talking about with radio and all. So we've never had to sit there try to figure out how to write, quote, a hit or something that's part of a sound or any of that.
That's what I think I admire most about Metallica. When I think back on your career, I think very early on you guys could have gotten very, I guess, self-conscious or kind of questioned the band because the songs weren't hits. And let's face it, it is a business. So you got to be able to make a living. But you didn't buckle. You know, you didn't change your sound at all.
It's also because I think all of us, in our own ways, have always felt kind of like outsiders. And
right.
We've never felt like we were part of the sort of the cool kids. Or we were all loners and outsiders and disenfranchised.
Yeah.
And always felt like we were kind of living in our own world and our own bubble.
So does it feel weird now to be accepted? Like you guys are considered a major touring act.
I still feel like we always hover on the outer fringes, that we're never part of the establishment. It's something that I still personally fight with.
We can always find something that we hate or they hate.
What,
and
yeah, right,
influences the next thing.
That hate will fire you up.
Yeah. Absolutely.
What was that?
What was even the beginning? We were writing music that we wanted to hear because the stuff we were hearing, we hated it.